is a presentation of how far I'm come with the rally computer project based on the Arduino Nano. Have had the first attempt. It works okay, but there's some problem with this the display. The biggest problem is in sunlight, you cannot see what's going on the display. Another problem is I think the display is too small. When the roads are bumpy and you are driving off-road, it's very hard to see what's standing here. And if there is rain also, it's very hard to see. So this one is out and are not in use anymore. We can try to turn it off and see what's inside here. The display, I had take the corner away so it fits down the enclosure here, and sit with this connection here, and the cable is also with a connection here, so it's very easy to remove it. And I've made some new holes here to three screws. When we power it up, you can see it's remember how far it's had gone. We have three things going on here. We have the total distance. It's go from 0 to 1,000 kilometers. Then we have the split distance. It goes from 0 to 100, and then we have the speed indicator here. It goes from 0 and to over 300 kilometers per hour. So I think to off-road use, the speed indicator will be enough. Here you can see how the rally computer get the signal. We have a magnetic switch here, and we have a magnet on this motor here. It simulates the front wheel of the motorbike. We have some four switches here. One for the display mode. This is mode 1, where you have the total distance, we have the split distance, and we have a speed indicator. The second screen here, we have the speed indicator, and we have the total distance. Here have we the total distance and the speed. And the last one, a very big speed indicator. If we press these two buttons at the same time, we are going to the setup mode. The first thing we can adjust here is the wheel, how big it is. And then we could go to the contrast here. We can adjust it from 0 to 100. Then we have the backlight. We can go to 0 and shut it off. And we could go to 100%. I think that's better here. And when we go to exit here and hold the button down here, all the figures will, all the values will be stored on the EEPROM. The same with the letters, or there's how the total and the speed is also stored on the speed, or on the EEPROM. When we are driving along here, and the total distance here, if it's if you want to adjust it, we can increase it here with this button here, or we can decrease it. With this one here, we can take the split and get it to zero, and we can also get the total to zero. And every time when the speed is zero, it stores the distance and all the values on the EEPROM. So if we shut the rally computer off now and turn it on again, we have the same distance as before. What's happening now is that I have to mount the rally computer on my motorbike and make some street and off-road test and see if it's works and as I thought it would. And after, when these tests are going well, all the code and all the documentation will be published on GitHub, so you can build your own rally computer. I hope you have enjoyed this presentation.